the milk. Oh, lick my lips.
Hey guys, this is Ethan Clark and welcome to Hot Buns. Today we've got our fabulous guest, Tice. So, you know, the owner, the CEO, the boss man. And we're gonna be running through a series of questions, working our way up as we go through 1 to 10 hot sauces.
So. Let's get it.
What made you start Pinnacle?
I've like PT slash coach for a while, and me and Ethan actually like met through the gym, and probably even more specifically like sports supplements were like some of the first things that we started talking about.
You're teasing me, it's always been like a passion of mine.
Like I've always loved sports supplements, loved training, and wanted to always build a bigger platform than just being this sauce is literally dripping on me already because I'm into it. So wanted to build a bigger platform than just being like a one-on-one coach, and so Pinnacle was the way that I decided to do that, building that platform where we can educate, inspire people, and you know, build a team full of cool people, which is what we're doing for the next like 9. No, we're sweet. That's like, that's literally sweet chili sauce, so we're good. I was like, I wonder if they're gonna stitch us up and put like, it's still hot for number one.
Well, while I got you there, like considering it is a supplement store, what was the first or your first pre-workout, something that really got you into gym supplements and supplements for lifestyle?
The first one that I ever had was C4. It's the exact same one that's like on the shelf still, just different packaging. And it was strawberry margarita.
You've been open for 4 years now, the store. So the weirdest, most uncomfortable moment that you've had in the shop, whether that's with a customer or, yeah, just elaborate. If you have the one time that you could pinpoint, what would it be?
Let me read this one out first too. So this is smoked hickory. So this is number 2. So I don't even know if this is gonna be hot. I didn't even think smoked hickory was gonna be hot. I'm gonna eat this and then I'm gonna answer the question. No, we're still good. We're still good. 2 years ago, we're in here. We're probably like 10, 15 minutes from closing. I don't know how many of you know this, but where we are located with the shop, like a stone throw that way, there's a pub. So like, we have had some characters in our time venture this way. The second thing as well, where the shop's located used to be a smoke bar. So like for the first like 2 years, we just get all these like characters come from the pub over here because they thought it was like a smoke bar. We had this one guy come over, right? This is gonna be a long story. So I don't know, we're gonna have to edit parts of it, but this guy's come in, he come in behind two like regular
customers. Are you sure about that?
Initially thought that he was just with them. And he's like coming in, he's like looking all the tubs, like he looked visibly like a bit, how you going? And then we asked him, we're like, oh, hey man, like are you all right? We had like music playing in the shop. He literally just started like screaming the lyrics of this song, like just singing like to the point where the other customers looked at him weird. And I was like, he is not with them. Like this is just some random guy. He started like reading off labels of tubs, but full knew what he was talking about, but like was clearly heavily intoxicated. And me and Ethan are both like looking at each other. No one knows what to do. This guy's like screaming lyrics, then asking like legitimate supplement questions, like legitimate questions about like dosages of certain ingredients in products. He was at the time, like I had my like ex partner here. He was like hitting on her. And then he was like, telling us, there was a point where we got to, and this is where it starts to get really weird. He started like singing lyrics of this song, but then he started asking us about like Jesus Christ and like if he's our Lord and Savior. He went from that to telling us that he had a gun, and then me and Ethan literally had to like physically maneuver this guy out of the shop. He was like singing, and we're like, mate, you gotta go, like you're scaring people. When he's like, you're just kicking me out, those blokes over there tried to kick me out and I'm not gonna let you kick me. But he literally had to manhandle this guy out of a shop, and he was heavily intoxicated. He then, for like the next hour, sat on the doorstep and we had to lock the door, and he's like leaning against the door and stuff. It was crazy. But yeah, that's that question. That was a long one.
Yeah,
no, that was a long one.
Alright, so where you got number 3?
Number 3. Verde green chili. Oh, this one's got a seal. Oh god, they're starting to have seals on them now. The first two didn't have seals. This one's got a seal on it. All right, let's go.
All right, while you're doing that, I'll ask you another question.
Yep,
let's go. You're pretty intuitive. A lot of people that follow you notice that you read a lot of books, everything like that. So you're always down the beach reading books. If you could only read one book for the rest of your life, what would it be? The one book.
They're already starting to kick. Oh man, that's three. That's three.
You did pour like half the thing.
Oh, I poured way too much on. One book. That's really, I feel like something philosophy based would have to be the way to go. And something big like that. Not some narrative. I would say meditations.
Yeah.
That would be my go-to. I was gonna try and like answer that smart and say some sort of like encyclopedia or like dictionary or something like that. But yeah,
no, that's good. Cool. I like that.
That would be my pick.
Yeah, that's good. No, fair enough. With the sports that you're doing at the moment, you've probably done a fair few sports in your life. Why you get the number four there. But jiu-jitsu, what would you feel is the hardest part about jiu-jitsu and what do you love mostly about it? Because it obviously is a pretty different sport that most people wouldn't understand. So what do you love most about it and what's the hardest part?
For me, I think the hardest part is getting humbled, being like manhandled by people that like physically you look at and think that you'd be able to be like, this shouldn't be happening. Like you like say like size and strength of like myself, like strength training for ages, even having like striking experience before and just looking at guys that you would just look at and think that you could take them. And then just getting annihilated by these guys. So probably mentally like breaking down these walls of like physical strength and like really it plays a factor but not as much as you think it would. And then I guess it's like I don't have a problem with it as such, but I think it might be hard. But going back to the point of just feeling stupid, so like literally starting something new and just having no idea what's going on, and like it feels like that for ages, like you just constantly feel like you're drowning until you slowly start to pick things up and you know learn different things, but just for a really long time and still all the time you just feel like you're drowning because you have no idea what's going on. So that's probably the hardest part, but there's so many good parts to it, but that would be the hardest part. It's just adapting to the concept that physical strength isn't gonna just get you through it, and technique means a lot. And then mentally, yeah, just getting comfortable being uncomfortable. That is probably the concept that I'm looking for. Getting comfortable being uncomfortable. Uncomfortable by just how close the contact sport it is, and being in just uncomfortable positions, like, you know, with people's hands, like, arms literally around your neck, choking you out. Alright, let's crank out this one. Number four, Mexican Chipotle. I gotta be careful, that last one came out so fast. I feel like surely the hotter they get, the... Man, okay. That's probably this. That is actually nicer than the third one. Isn't it weird? That last one, my head was like sweating, and now my like lips are like sweating, bro. Like, man. Alright.
Not too bad.
That's alright. It's kind of creeping up on me now, but.
So we're at next. Five's next.
This is five.
Five.
Alright, so like now that's actually getting like hotter. It's not, still not too bad. I'm alright. Alright, let's go.
Okay, so whether it be in sport, out of sport, business, lifestyle, who would be your biggest idol? What would you say, and somebody you'd love to meet one day if you haven't already met them?
Oh man, I don't know. When it comes to fitness, someone like Ross Edgley, that would be really cool to meet someone like that. So someone who's done these just like crazy physical feats, because I feel like there would just be so many like questions about like mindset I'd like to ask them, or ask someone like him. Someone like The Rock would be really cool as well to ask someone like that. They're like, I keep looking at the gluten-free sign. Maybe that, I don't know if that's gonna help me at all, but bread number five. This one's coming out way slower I have no idea what that means, but now I've got to start being more conservative with this, right? Surely. Now, what number do I have to start being more conservative? Maybe I should show the camera how much I put on it every time, so I don't think I'm being a puss. That one smells hotter, like. Initially up front, that doesn't really have much, to be honest. I hope I get through this and I'm like unscathed. Unscathed. That was not too bad.
Not too bad?
No, we're not too bad there.
Beautiful. All right, we'll go into number six then, considering we're just over halfway now. A lot of people who know you also, or maybe people that don't know that you love video games, so esports, all that sort of stuff. That's what you like to do in your downtime. So when did you first get addicted? What made you addicted, or what made you love video games?
So, fortunately, I have not invested as much time into games as I used to as a teenager, I guess since starting Pinnacle, because otherwise it probably would never even exist. But throughout my teenage years, it was like pretty much everything. I think the one game that would be like, I know where this question come from too, I saw it come in, it comes from a mate who is the reason I even got into this game. But World of Warcraft was one game that I invested bonkers amount of time into when I was growing up. Like,
it's fucking Jake.
Yeah, it was Jake. Jake R. So, bonkers amount of time into that game. And, man, like, I was heavily addicted to that. And then it was kind of like different games like COD and League of Legends and all stuff, but that was the one that was just like, had me by the throat, like high school. and like, to be honest, like, I think it's like helped me a lot, even with Pinnacle, like, because we do a lot with esports and we do a lot of content orientated around like gamers like transitioning into fitness. And like, even I feel like we produce a lot of like layman's term type content, really the kind of content that I wish I had when I was like trying to transition into fitness after being like heavily addicted to video games and like breaking in. And like, then, you know, I want to try and be that almost like same platform for those people that are like looking to live a healthier lifestyle coming from gaming. And now I still play games, but just, yeah, not that much. I try and do more productive shit now, like, and just really dial it back. All right, number six, Louisiana Habanero. Let's go. I'm gonna put a little bit more on with this one. I feel like surely I gotta put on like a bit of a show.
I got a bit more.
Bit more?
More.
Alright, yeah. That's heaps. Jesus Christ. What are you? Yeah, I feel that one, eh? I feel that one. Oh, dude. My head's ringing a bit, eh?
It's not bad.
No, I'll wait. No,
not going for it yet?
No, that's hot. There's something to get up there.
Good?
My nose is running and my head is like sweating, eh?
Alrighty, so while that one sinks in, another question that we had was, it's not really a question, but more of a statement as well. What is your favourite music genre and why is it country?
Because country's the best. Man, you know, like, when now that we've been like training outside, I get to like pick, man, my tongue is on fire. Like the tip of my tongue. Oh, God. So like, I get to pick the music. I don't know, at what point is my brain gonna stop working? Let's get into this point now. Yeah, I get to pick the music we're playing, and it's like, I'll play music for my clients, like when we're training, and it'll be country. And it's like 50% of my clients are like roasting me, 100% of my friends roast me, and then 50% are like, hell yeah. But every time I'm in the shop, we're listening to country. Crystal and Ethan are definitely sick of it. But in saying that, Ethan starts singing parts of songs now because he's listening to it so much. He's like literally started singing lyrics. He knows lyrics. I had Mason in the car and they'll start singing like things to like Morgan Wallen and like Jason Aldean and Luke Combs. They've like heard the songs that I've played like a million times. But I don't know, I've like grown up listening to country. That's definitely a mother's influence thing, but she listened to like, you know, Dixie Chicks and Lee Kernaghan and Adam Breen and stuff, and I think I listened to more like new school stuff. So yeah.
I'm not gonna lie, country is better than we used to have a song that got played in store that Tyson loved. It was specifically related to crabs.
Oh, yeah.
And Andrew, who'll be out there watching this, you know exactly what I'm talking about. It played non-stop, so country is better than that, but
yeah. Crab Rave, if anyone wants to know. Crab Rave. That was the song that used to go on repeat in the shop just for the meme, the pure meme. All right, let's go. Number seven, lucky seven. Tropical Caribbean. All right, let's go.
Be generous.
Is that in focus, Tay? Can we see? Can the people see this?
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus.
Either that asked him a question.
Man.
A question at the same time?
Yeah, go.
Jesus. All right, let's go.
So we've got another question here. Who would be your biggest celebrity crush? Celebrity crush. So anyone, somebody you really like, fitness wise, movies, singers, anything.
Okay. All right. So. Oh man. Maybe it's only because it's recent. But Scarlett Johansson. Man. It's gotta be a Black Widow thing, like surely. Because I'm a Marvel fan and like literally maybe just re-watching or watching Black Widow the other day. Fuck me, man. It's like working its way up my mouth. Like the last one started with my tongue and now this one I feel it in my cheeks. My head is wet. I'm actually like sweating out my hair product. Yeah, it'd have to be Scarlett Johansson, I think.
Alright, so while we're on the topic of celebrities, which celebrity do you think you look like? So, rate yourself. I know you do, so what celebrity do you think you look like? Like, is it, are we staying with the Marvel theme with like Chris Pratt, like Captain America, is that what we're doing, or?
Look like Buff Woody.
Buff Woody? I think you're gonna be like Woody Harrelson or something. I don't know what's going on with that. Can I say Thor, just for
you
the sake of it?
You can say Thor.
Everyone's gonna be like, this guy's fucking ego is huge. FYI, I have to have an ego because like everyone that I hang around just annihilates me on a daily basis. I'm not allowed an ego. Even this morning, just having conversations with people and they were just like, just giving me shit all the time. And they're like, you know, we have to do this. And I'm like, well, my ego's not even that bad. Well, clearly, I think I look like Thor. Apparently, not at the moment. Like that guy looks insane at the moment. Filming for like Thor, Love and Thunder. Now they're dark, so this is where it's starting to get scary. Chipotle Reaper, brainchild of Cully's master sorcerer Chris Cullen, Smokey and blah blah blah. It just says. Our Chipotle Reaper is a deliciously hot and smoky, spicier version of our number four. Oh my god, some come out like slow. And others come out, do I do that, all of that?
Yeah,
give it a crack.
That's actually, oh man. You know what, now because we've only got two left, I feel like I gotta like turn it up a little bit. Let's go. Man, my head, like, I don't know, hang on. Can I, ready? See that? My head is so wetty. I'm just trying to keep myself together. I'm doing a pretty good job, I feel like. Water does nothing to, FYI. I did bring milk and stuff. I think that's in the camera shot, right? I need this now, to be honest. That's actually pretty light.
Do you want some Red Bull?
Isn't that crazy how, oh my god. It's like, it doesn't even actually, worse, I was gonna say, it doesn't actually, it's just like, the milk's in your mouth. Oh man, that's fucking pretty shit, eh?
Oh, thank God.
Do you want the next one?
Next question, yeah, the next wing, nah.
Yeah, so, while we're on to the next one, yeah. We were just talking about, you reckon you look like Thor, so, you rate yourself. If you could, if you could be any superhero, it doesn't have to be looks or anything like that, and you could have any superpower, what would it be? So, along those lines.
Okay. Oh man, it's actually getting so bad, eh? Oh, fuck, that sucks. That sucks so much. That's 8. What is there, 2 to go? My eyes watering. Oh my god. Okay. If I could have any superhero powers. Oh man. Okay.
Mine's finally left his body.
Man, my brain's actually not working now. Oh, it'd have to be some sort of like, something like Jean Grey, like some sort of like telekinetic and like powers, something like that. It's not even the word, that's not even the correct word, but like, oh man, that one's still getting bad. And it's the ghost chili one next. Oh man.
Okay. Surely you double dab all of them.
How does it, it literally went like 7 was like, oh, it was like not too bad. Oh fuck. Yeah, something like Jean Grey or something just like honestly like Superman would just be the bomb because he's just the strongest one going. Alright. Let's get this number 9 baby, number 9. Oh, look, how many questions have we, what have we got? How many have we got left?
One left. So we'll get this one
then. One left, alright. Okay. So let me pump this one down. Oh, hang on, let me hold it up. Tell me if it's in focus. Oh, jeez Louise, mate.
Yeah.
Are we good?
Yeah.
They're coming out quick. That's alright. That's a lot.
You can go a bit more.
Jeez. Look at this. Hang on. Bro, I don't even know if people can see that, but I am dying here. Ugh. Oh my god, I'm getting burps and shit. Let's do this. Oh man. I feel like I gotta, cause it got, I gotta not pussy this out. Let's do it. Oh fuck man. That's not fun, eh? Like, that's actually dog shit. It doesn't even taste, that one tastes like shit as well. Like, the hotter they get, the worse they taste. Like, it doesn't even have taste now. It just tastes like hot. Fuck me. My eyes won't stop watering. Ethan's loving this, man.
Oh my god. You're a...
Oh man, give me 10k calories. Oh,
your head's like shiny.
Is it?
Yeah, a little bit.
Oh, this is the best.
How so like fun. How much of it?
I'm having so much fun.
Oh man, look at the sweat on the side of my head. Do I just look like I'm dying? Like, oh my god. Oh. Oh my god. Oh. Oh man, that
one. I don't know if the, was the lemon, does the lemon help?
It's meant to. It doesn't. It's meant to help. I was watching Gordon Ramsay, like, on his one. Fuck, is it getting worse than that? Oh. Oh man. Alright, let's go. Last one. Fuck, let's get this over and done with, eh?
Yeah, you got number 10 to go.
Oh, we gotta get this out of the way, man, so I can go home and cry.
But if you were on a deserted island and you had one other person there with you, so it wasn't deserted, but like you're there with another person, who would you want to be there with? And what would be the one thing that you would take with you? What would be the one thing?
Not hot sauce. One thing. Fuck.
I reckon you should dab that last one up before you answer this question.
Oh, okay.
Start eating
it. Yeah, let me get this down and then I'll try and think
of
it.
Come on, show us how much you're putting on.
Fuck. Oh, dude. I'm dying. It's going to be like a mound of paper towel here after this.
I can't wait for this one, honestly. If anyone knows how easy Tice did the 10K challenge, how much I struggled, this is making me so happy right now. So anyone out there, I hope you're enjoying this as much as
I haven't even got past the 9. The 9's still there. Oh, you fucking asshole, man, honestly. You're fucked. Oh. Oh, fucking dog. Oh my lord. Oh. I'm actually like, I was actually trying to be conservative then too. Dude, I can see, oh my god. Can you see the chunks? Can you see the chunks in that?
Yeah.
All right, let me get this. Oh my god. The 9's still there. Like, the 9 is still kicking my fucking ass right now. Oh, dude, actually.
Just go back. It's the last one. Just give it your all.
Come on.
Last one. You gotta finish strong.
Oh man.
You got the last 50 meters. That's all it is.
Oh man, it's destroying me.
So I'm gonna assume you won't be on Discord tonight.
I'll be dead. R.I.P.
Alrighty. So back to the question.
Oh.
Deserted island. Fuck the question. One person. One thing. Let's see if you can answer it while it's kicking in.
Oh. No, man. Oh. Man, the milk. Oh, lick my lips. Ah! Oh. One person, one thing.
Yeah, one person, one thing.
You and a gun. Oh, I'm drooling. Every time I lick my lips, it goes on my lips, man. Oh! Oh, man. Are they alive or dead?
Nah, they're alive. So.
I'm like crying.
That's actual tea, everyone, so.
This is actually so much harder than I thought it was gonna be. One person, fuck.
One person, one thing. Who would it be? What would you take? Food.
Man, yeah, I was gonna say, is it like.
Phone? Maybe that'll get you out of there.
Oh, yeah, if we're thinking of shit to get me out of there, fuck, man. No, I say. Oh, man. Oh. I'll get there.
I'll walk it off for a sec.
Yeah. I'll come back and do it a lap. Oh.
I'm actually crying, eh?
Oh, God. Oh. 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 Every time I lick my lips. I gotta stop that. How much milk am I gonna drink? Like, at what point am I just going home to crap my pants?
You're unintentionally doing the milk challenge while you're doing this.
I'm literally, like, I'm gonna be drinking, like, nearly 1,000 calories in milk, bro. We'll get there. This is all staying in this footage. One person.
It's the teardrop.
What did I say? Just like one of the guys that I was wanted to meet, like.
Yeah. So would it be your idol? Would it be someone they'd love to spend like a week stranded with, like, just to get as much knowledge out of them as you can?
You know who'd be? You know what? Maybe someone heaps funny that I love, like Andrew Schultz, Ryan Reynolds, Chris Pratt. Someone heaps funny, so I'd be like entertained the whole time. And then a phone, so I could just like get out of there, surely, at some stage.
No, that's fair enough, that's fair.
Oh my god. Alright. I had a question for you now. How much are you enjoying this?
I'm actually enjoying this. If you couldn't tell by my face, this is the best I get up, so.
Oh man. Smell that.
Have you tried it?
No, I haven't.
Have Tell me, jump out a little bit.
Yeah, just put like.
Just dip your finger on it a little bit. Like, just do a little bit
on there. Oh, man.
You'll see why he's like dying, because it's pretty fucked. That's like a flake.
Yeah. Is that bad?
That's
bad.
Don't you, bro.
No, I don't want it.
Oh, man. Oh, man. That's how
it's like
the bottle.
Oh my god.
Yeah, it's instant. It's not like a delay.
Oh man, I'm like burping now.
That's why when you put so much on, I was fucking losing it.
So how's this? I love how they describe hot sauce too, and they're like, oh yeah, like fucking how it tastes. It tastes like shit. Not for the faint of heart, the flavour of the Reaper chili is complimented. Or else not. By no heathens, by notes of rich, sweet bell peppers. Followed by insane heat. Oh.
Like a fire on your tongue.
Yeah, it's bad, man. All right, well. All right. I think we're done, eh? All right, how are we gonna tie this off? Thanks for watching. Honestly, I hope you people enjoyed this, because that is like, I can't even think, man. But that was suffering, and it still is suffering, to be honest. But if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to, oh my god, look at this, my head is soaked. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And what else do they have to do? Subscribe. I didn't prompt that, so it was gonna be confused as fuck.